गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ क्लास 8th फॉर मैथ सब्जेक्ट. स्टूडेंट्स, बिफोर स्टार्टिंग चैप्टर नंबर 17, दैट इज़ ग्राफ, लेट मी टेक द प्लेज रिगार्डिंग COVID-19. आई कमिट टू बी विलियंट एंड बियर इन माइंड एट ऑल टाइम्स द रिस्क टू माई सेल्फ एंड माई कोलीग्स फ्रॉम COVID-19. I promise to take all necessary precautions that prevent the spread of this deadly virus. I promise to follow and encourage others to follow the key COVID appropriate behaviors. To always wear a mask, face cover, especially when in public places. To maintain a minimum distance of 6 feet from others. To wash my hands frequently and thoroughly with soap and water. Together we will win this fight against COVID-19. Thank you. So students, today I will start chapter number 17, that is graph. So why do we draw graph? It's same like a map. Why map is used? It is used to find the location of something. So here in the book is it is given ki, for example, you have to find your position in class, you have to tell ki in which rows you are sitting and which columns. Suppose here I am telling ki my location is in fourth row and third column. So this one is the fourth row and third column. So here is the my position. Similarly, maps are used to find the location. So here, like this fourth row and third column, just we will write 4, 3 is the coordinates. These are the coordinates of student or me that I am using. So similarly, students, graphs are used to find the location of point. Hum point ki location find karni hai. So we will draw the graph. Kisi bhi point ko show karna hai aapne graph ke upar ki uski position kya hai. To hum graphs use karte hai. Isme bache, firstly we need coordinates. So to use the coordinate system to locate point on a plane, we need a point. जिस पॉइंट को आपने लोकेट करना है वो पॉइंट चाहिए. देन अ हॉरिजेंटल लाइन अलोंग विच द हॉरिजेंटल डिस्टेंसिस आर मेजर्ड. हॉरिजेंटल लाइन, देन वी विल नीड वर्टिकल लाइन. सो हेयर इज ऑल्सो साइन कन्वेंशन. आई विल गिव द डिटेल टू यू. सो टू ड्रॉ द ग्राफ, this one is vertical line, this one is horizontal line. They will meet at origin O. This will the origin. So here we will write x axis. This horizontal line is known as x axis and vertical line is known as y axis. I think this is clear to you. This horizontal line is known as x-axis and vertical line is known as y-axis. So on the right hand side we will take positive values of x. We will take the positive value of x, and on the left hand side we will take negative value of the x. And for this vertical line, upper side we will take the positive value and downwards we will take negative value of the y. This is very important. So bache, this is the coordinate system. So this is the first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. This will be anti-clockwise. First quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. Like here we will write positive value of x. So here I will put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so on. And on the left hand side, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, and so on. And the upper side, we will write positive value of y. And downward, we will write negative value of the y. So, in the coordinate pair, so if we will write the position of the point, we will write in bracket. Firstly, we will write the coordinate of x. X ka coordinate likhenge, then value of our y. X wale ko hum bolte abscissa. Abscissa. And y is also known as ordinate. Ordinate. Okay, when we will locate the point, firstly we will write the value of x, comma, then value of y. So here in first quadrant, x values are also positive and y value is also positive. Both values are positive. And in the second quadrant, x value is negative and y one is positive. In the third quadrant, x value is negative and also your y value is negative. Then in fourth quadrant, value of x is positive and value of y is negative. So by just observation, we can tell that ki in which quadrant this point will lie. Suppose I have point 3, 5. So by observation, these two points are positive. So in the first quadrant, both are positive. So this point will lie in the first quadrant. Suppose I have point minus 3, 4. So here x is negative and y is positive. So this will lie in second quadrant. I think this concept is clear to you. Now next exercise is, we will do question number 1 only here. Draw the axis and plot the following points on a graph paper. You can also take graph paper from the market also. Also you can draw on the notebook. So these are the axis, x-axis, y-axis. This one is 0. Here positive value of x. Then negative value of x on the left hand side. Then here is positive value of y. Then negative value of y. So here first question is 1, 5. 1, 5. It means value of x is 1 and value of y is 5. Both are positive, so it will lie in the first quadrant. So bachche, 1 is here and 5 is here. Extend them and they will join here. Okay, extend karlo with the help of pencil. It will meet here. So this point is 1, 5. This point has this location. Then next is 3, 4. Value of x is 3 and value of y is 4. So 3 is here, then 4 is here. This point is the location for second point. Then third point is minus 2, 4. Minus 2 is here and 4 is positive. So here they will meet. Minus 2, 4. Next one is minus 4, 4. Minus 4 is here and 4 is here. This one. So like this you can plot the graph of the given points. So students, that's all for today. Up to here you have to revise for today. Thank you and have a nice day.